Claudia Cooper from Coop's Kitchen Corner with Fast Pitch Prep. I want to talk to you guys a little bit today about the new obstruction rule and how you as catchers and how coaches your catchers can possibly avoid this call being called on your catchers. So what I want to talk to you guys about first is where to set up when receiving a ball from the outfield or having a play at the plate. So we've kind of drawn a semi-baseline here, and here's home plate in this position. So first thing that your catcher wants to do is come out in front of the plate in well enough time to be able to set herself up and see where the ball is. So a few things to keep in mind. Per the obstruction rule, if the catcher's body gets within the base runner's line at any time before they possess the ball, they could be called for obstruction. Or it's a lot more noticeable if they get called for obstruction. So a few things I would just say is if their foot is on the foul line before the ball is being thrown, or before the ball gets to them, that could be called for obstruction. If their foot is within the baseline and the point of the plate here, like so, could be called for obstruction. So what I like to tell my catchers to do is to put their left foot just slightly in front of the corner of the bag, like so. If they're set up here in this position, they're in a good position to not be called for obstruction because they're not impeding the baseline from that runner, okay? Now, here's the tricky part of this rule. For so long, we've taught our catchers to go ahead and start moving as we're receiving the ball so we can better protect ourselves in case a runner comes in either up or comes in on a bad slide and knocks us over. That's no longer something that we can do. The minute the umpire sees us moving in the act of catching the ball, we're going to be called for obstruction. So it has to be more of a bang bang play. We have to catch and then start moving ourselves to get in a good position to make that tag. So we want to make sure that we're teaching our catchers to get in a good position, a good athletic position. I'm moving my feet, I'm bouncing around, and what I want to do is I want to catch, receive that ball in close, and then you can drop both or one knee, doesn't matter, as long as they're getting in front of the runner, they're tagging them really nice and low. I like to teach to step over, and then I'm going to drop that back knee here, and I'm going to tag low, because I also keep my body facing the field to be able to throw in case I have a trail runner. But again, I cannot move until that ball is in my glove. So we've got to make sure that our catchers are catch, and then we're moving our feet quick to be able to make that tag down in front, and then we're blocking that runner. Now, a few things that I want to talk to you guys about if runners do a hook slide and they come back around the plate like so. If I'm right here in this position, I'm still waiting to catch the ball, but a lot of things I see catchers doing is they go down, that runner is hook sliding, try to catch the back of the plate, and catchers go across and try to tag the runner here. At that point in time, you've already missed the runner. They have to come back to the plate. So a lot of things I teach my catchers is as soon as you catch the ball, you tag right to that plate every single time. So I'm here, if she hook slides, my glove goes around the back of the plate because she's got to touch that plate. So I want to make sure that I'm always going back to the plate instead of going for the runner. So when I go for the runner, I might actually go for her feet and her hands back here, touching the plate, and she's going to be safe. As catchers, we want nobody to score, especially if we've got a chance to have a play at the plate. It's probably one of the most exciting things about catching. So a little bit of the obstruction rule. Make sure that your catchers are setting up correctly to hopefully avoid your catchers and your team getting called for an obstruction. Key things to remember is that we have to catch the ball first before we start moving to get our body in front. So that's plays at the plate. A little bit about keeping everything in front of us and avoiding that obstruction rule. So blocking the plate 101.